Good afternoon. Today we will start on lecture number 10. It is all about numericals. Today we will just repeat the problems, whatever has been done. We will work out more problems today. Okay. The first one is find the total current in outward direction from a cube of 1 meter with one corner at the origin and edges parallel to the coordinate axis. If J vector is equal to 2x square ax cap plus 2xy cube ay cap plus 2xy az cap ampere per meter square. Okay. The cube is shown here, okay, which with all sides will be equal to 1 meter. Okay. According to continuity equation, we know current I will be equal to surface integral J dot ds or volume integral divergence of J dv. Okay, this is the Gauss divergence theorem. The cube here is uses a differential volume of dx into dy into dz. Okay, where divergence of J, as you all know, it is dou by dou x of jx plus dou by dou y of jy plus dou by dou z of jz. Okay. So, if you do dou by dou x of jx, it is 2x square. If you differentiate, it is 4x. Then dou by dou y of this component 2xy cube, differentiation with respect to y gives you 2x into y cube differentiation is into 3y square. So, it results as 6xy square. Okay. And dou by dou z of z component, it is 2xy, but there is no z here. So, 2xy is a constant. So, dou by dou z of this constant will be 0. Hence, it is 4x plus 6xy square. So, this is the divergence of it. Further, to find current I, it is volume integral this divergence of J over a differential volume, that is dx into dy into dz. So, which will be equal to integral z between 0 to 1, y between 0 to 1 and x from 0 to 1. This divergence of J over a differential volume, it is dx into dy into dz. Okay. Hence, it becomes volume integral. So, first we have to integrate this with respect to x. So, x is nothing but 4x square by 2. Again, integration of this will be 6x square by 2 into y square as it is. Then, after that, we will substitute the limit for x equal to 0 to 1, which results as 2 plus 3y square. Okay. Then, integration with respect to y, this will become 2y, this will become 3y cube by 3. Okay, and 3 and 3 can be get cancelled, substituting the limits, then it will become 2 plus 1. So, it is 3 dz. Okay, then integrating with respect to that, so it will become 3z and substituting the limit, so it will become 3. Okay, so the current entry dose will be equal to 3 amperes. So, what are we trying to do here is, first thing is, a divergence of J has been found, and then finding the current I using volume integral divergence of J over a differential volume. Next, we'll take the second problem. It is the current density vector is given by J vector equal to 2 by r square cos theta into air gap plus 20 into e power minus 2 r sin theta a theta cap minus r sin theta cos phi a phi cap ampere per meter square. Okay. Find current density at r equal to 3 meters and theta equal to 0 degree and phi equal to pi. Okay. This is what the data given. So, first thing is we have to find out J vector at this point P. Okay. So, this is a direct substitution for R is nothing but 3 and this theta, wherever theta is there, it should be substituted as 0 and wherever phi is there, here it is phi, that should be substituted as pi. pi. Okay. So by substituting the respective r, theta and phi values, j vector will result as 0.222 ar cap ampere per meter square. Okay. Further, part b is find the total current passing through the spherical surface r equal to 3 meter and theta between 0 to 20 degree and phi between 0 to 2 pi in ar cap direction. So again we have to find out the current I. So current I is what? It is surface integral j dot ds vector. Okay, so ds vector is in ar cap direction, so that is r square sin theta into d theta d phi ar cap. Okay, so this is the surface differential surface area of our constant r. Okay, so current I will be surface integral j dot this differential surface area. Hence it becomes, it is, what is j is given in the problem, it is 2 by r square cos theta into ar cap plus some theta component and some phi component. But here what is the current passing through this radial direction, this surface area has been asked. Okay, so hence it has to be considered here, it is only 2 by r square cos theta, because ar dot ar will be 1, a theta dot ar is 0, as well as ar dot a phi is 0. Only resulting is this radial component, that is 2 by r square cos theta. Hence it becomes 2 by r square cos theta into this differential surface area, that is r square sin theta d theta and d phi. Okay, so where theta integration limit is 0 to 20 degree and phi limits are 0 to 2 pi. Okay, and cos theta into sin theta, 2 cos sin theta can be written as sin 2 theta. Okay, and sin 2 theta integration is minus cos 2 theta divided by 2. Okay, then substitute the limit as 0 to 20 degree and d phi integration is phi. And then substituting the limit for phi 0 to 2 pi, it results as, with this numerical calculation, it results as 0.735 amps. Okay, so current passing through the radial direction, it is 0.735 amps. Let us consider the third problem. It is find the current crossing the portion of y equal to 0 plane defined by x equal to minus 0.1 to plus 0.1 meter and z between minus 0.002 to 0.002 meter if j vector is 10 square into x ay cap, where j vector is the current density. So this is what given, j vector is given. We have to find out the current crossing the portion for y equal to 0 plane. Okay, as you know, if you take this as x axis, this one as y axis and this as z axis, this xz plane, this xz plane is nothing but it is the y equal to 0 plane. Okay, so hence we'll find out here current I equal to surface integral j dot ds. For y equal to 0 plane, it is nothing but dx into dz. Okay, for a constant y plane, the surface area is written or defined as, it is dx into dz ay cap. Okay, so by taking this y component here, 10 square x into ay cap dot dx dz ay cap, where ay cap is the unit vector. Okay, so it comes as 10 square x into dx dz. So integrating this x into dx will become x square by 2. Then dz integration is nothing but z. Okay, and then substituting the limits, for z it is 0.002 to minus of minus 0.002 and x limit is 0 to 0.1. By substituting this limit, it will, the answer is 4 milliamps. Okay, so the given the current and the surface area we are trying to find out. Given the current density and the surface area, we are trying to find out the current I. We'll take the fourth problem. It is an electric field strength 3 volt per meter in air enters a dielectric. Okay, the orientation of electric fields with respect to boundary in air and dielectric are 30 degree and 60 degree respectively. Find the relative permittivity of the dielectric. Also find the electric field strength in the dielectric. Okay, so we'll try to do this. So here there is a field strength of 3 volt per meter in air. Okay, in air it is 3 volt per meter. It enters a dielectric. Okay, if you consider this as air, this is air. You consider this is the air. So from here the field intensity is falling like this. Okay, and then it is over this boundary, it is diverging and then it is giving some other electric field intensity entering into the dielectric medium. Maybe having a this dielectric medium is having a permittivity, relative permittivity epsilon r 2. Okay, so at the boundaries, the solution goes like this. At the boundary, this angle theta 1, this angle theta 1 with respect to the normal, it is nothing but 90 degree minus 30 degree. Okay, because with this horizontal, this angle is given as 30 degree. Okay, so hence theta 1, this whole thing is 90 degree, and theta 1 is 90 minus 30 will be equal to 60 degree. Okay, whereas theta 2, this angle theta 2 will be again 90 minus 60, so angle theta 2 will become 30 degree. Okay, we know the boundary condition. Okay, at the two perfect dielectrics, the boundary condition is dn1 equal to dn2, or it can be written as the E, if electric field intensity, normal component en1 divided by en2 will be equal to epsilon 2 by epsilon 1, because this dn1 can be written as epsilon 1 into e1, this dn2 can be written as epsilon 2 into e2. Okay, while the tangential components, that is one more boundary condition, E tan 1 equal to E tan 2, are D tan 1 divided by D tan 2 equal to epsilon 1 by epsilon 2. Okay, using this boundary condition, what we'll do, we can further rewrite as tan theta 1 by tan theta 2 equal to epsilon 1 by epsilon 2. So this has been found also in the boundary conditions. Okay, in that we have derived this one. So if by cancelling this epsilon naught with epsilon naught, it is epsilon r1 by epsilon r2. Okay, whereas epsilon r1 value is equal to 1 because it is in the air. Okay, so it becomes 1 by epsilon r2. So what is theta 1? It is 60 degree and theta 2 is 30 degree. By substituting that, we will get the answer for epsilon r2. So here it goes as 0.333. Further, we can find cos theta 1 can be written as en1 by e1. Okay, from this figure, if you take this is normal component en1, this is nothing but e1. So En1 is nothing but adjacent to this angle. So you can write En1 equal to E1 into cos theta 1. Okay. So En1 is nothing but E1 into cos theta 1, or cos theta 1 is En1 by E1. Okay. Similarly, cos theta 2 will become En2 divided by E2. Okay. So this is the angle theta 2. So this adjacent to this angle, it is en2. So en2 can be written as this e2 multiplied by cos theta 2. Okay. Hence, cos theta 2 is en2 by e2, or en2 is e2 into cos theta 2. So if by dividing this cos, this these two equation, so cos theta 1 by cos theta 2 can be written as this divided by this, or en1 by e1 into e2 divided by en2. Okay, 1 by this, 1 by this. Okay, so it is nothing but en1 by e1 into e2 divided by en2. But We know this ratio En1 by En2 is nothing but epsilon2 by epsilon1 by the boundary condition, because dN1 equal to d2, so En1 by En2 is epsilon2 by epsilon1. Further using this, it will become cos 60 divided by cos 30 will be equal to epsilon2 by epsilon1 multiplied by E2 by E1. So it becomes 0.5 divided by 0.860 equal to 1 by 0.33 into E2 by 3. So further, E2 will result as 0.5767 volt per meter. So E2 is this, because E1 as given in the problem, E1 is equal to 3 volt per meter. Only thing is, we have to find out the what is the field intensity which has been entered into the dielectric medium. Okay, the answer is here, it goes like this, it is equal to 0.57 volt per meter. Okay, so we can see the change entered is 3 volt per meter, but once it is entered into the dielectric, it has been reduced into 0.5767 because of the dielectric difference between air to the dielectric medium. Further, we'll consider one more problem. There is a region for Z less than 0 is composed of a uniform dielectric material with epsilon r equal to 3.2, and the region Z greater than 0 is characterized by epsilon r equal to 2. Okay, if d1 vector is minus 30 ax cap plus 50 ay cap plus 70 az cap nano coulomb per meter, determine d2 component, theta1 and theta2 angles. Okay, so we know the boundary condition, that is et1 equal to et2 r. We can write dt1 by epsilon 1 r1 is equal to dt2 by epsilon r2. Okay, and one more condition is dn1 equal to dn2. Okay, here the normal component is along the z direction. Okay, you have a plane for z equal to 0, so the normal component will be along the z direction, and from the boundary condition dn1 is equal to dn2. Here normal component is 70 az because it must be in the z direction, so dn2 also will be equal to this 70 az cap. dn1 is same as dn2, which will be equal to 70 az cap. Okay, further, that means this remaining minus 30 ax cap plus 50 ay cap will be the tangential component. Okay, so where this d2 vector can be written as some x component plus y component and then the z component. Already we have this normal component, which is the z component. Only tangential d2 component we have to find. Okay, where using this dt1 by epsilon r1, it is minus 30 divided by this dt1 is nothing but this minus 30 divided by epsilon r1. Epsilon r1 is 3.2 and epsilon r2 is 2. So substituting here by epsilon r2 is nothing but 2. Substituting here, we get the d2 x component. Okay, that is nothing but minus 18.75. Okay, so to find out d2 y component, it is nothing but this 15 divided by 3.2 and d2 y divided by this epsilon r2, which is equal to 2. Hence we get d2 y equal to 31.25. okay, hence we got this d2x, d2y and then the d2z also. Okay, so we get d2 vector equal to x component, y component and the z component. This whole thing is tangential and this 70 az cap is the normal component. Okay, then further, in order to find out the angles, what you can do is, if you do d1 dot az cap, it is nothing but d1 magnitude into cos theta 1. Okay, because what do you get if you find d1? Okay, if you find d1 dot product with az cap, okay, if you do d1 dot product with az cap, it gives you d1 into cos theta 1, which is nothing but only 70, because if you do ax dot az, it is 0, ay dot az is 0, only you will get 70, az dot az is 1, so you will get only 70. So you will get it as d1 dot az is nothing but 70, which can be written as d1 magnitude into cos theta 1. Okay. So what is d1 magnitude? Root of that x component square plus y component square plus z component square. So results as 91.1. Okay. Hence theta 1 will be cos inverse of 70 divided by 91. Answer is 39.79 degrees. Okay. Similarly, if you do d2 dot az cap, it is 70 and it gives you d2 into cos theta 2. So d2 magnitude, by finding d2 magnitude similar to d1 magnitude, it is 78.98. Okay. Hence theta 2 will be cos inverse of this 70 divided by this magnitude 78, which results in 27.5 degrees. Okay. So we got the angle theta 1, we got the angle theta 2. So next thing is, okay, we have got d2, theta 1 and theta 2. Okay. Further, it has been found that tan theta 1 by tan theta 2 is nothing but epsilon r1 by epsilon r2. So tan theta 1 by tan theta 2, if you do, it gives you 1.599. Similarly, if you do epsilon r1 by epsilon r2 also, it approximately gives you 1.6. Hence, you can say that tan theta 1 by tan theta 2 is equal to epsilon r1 by epsilon r2. Okay, with the numerical calculation also, with this particular problem, you can say that this ratio is equal to epsilon r1 by epsilon r2. We'll consider the sixth problem. It is two cubes of dielectric materials have a common face in the xy plane. Okay, in the xy plane, that is that you can tell it is a constant z plane. Okay, an electric field vector E vector equal to 3 ax cap plus 4 ay cap minus 12 az cap volt per meter in cube 2 with z greater than 0. This is the field. Okay. The material of which has a relative permittivity equal to 4. This material is having a relative permittivity 4. Find D vector in cube 1. The material of which has a relative permittivity 2. Okay. So there are two cubes which are sharing the same plane. So from cube 2, there is a field intensity, and then in the cube 2, what is the permittivity has been given. In the cube 1, permittivity is given, but you have to find out the electric flux density D vector. Okay. So you can tell E2 is given, you have to find out D1 vector. Okay. So as you know, at the dielectric interface, you can write ET1 equal to ET2. Okay. Here, since again it is a constant Z plane, the cubes are sharing a constant Z plane, your normal component will be in the Z direction. Okay. Hence, this minus 12 az cap is nothing but the normal component. So, tangential component is 3 ax cap plus 4 ay cap. Okay. As you know, ET1 equal to ET2, you can write 3 ax plus 4 ay is same as ET2. Okay. And ET1. So, what is EN1 you have to find. Okay. So at the boundary, you know, DN1 equal to DN2. Okay. So it is epsilon naught epsilon R1 E1 is equal to epsilon naught epsilon R2 into EN2. Okay. Where EN1 will be equal to EN2 into epsilon R2 divided by epsilon R1. By cancelling this epsilon naught with this epsilon naught, you get this answer. Okay. Further, hence the field intensity at cube 1 can be written as this is the normal component. It is 3 ax cap plus 4 ay minus 24 az. Okay. If you multiply this with the er1, okay, what is er1? Which is equal to 2. If you will get the d vector. Okay. So if you multiply this e1 multiplied by epsilon 1, where epsilon 1 is epsilon naught into epsilon r1. If you multiply that, you will get d1 vector. Okay. Now we'll take next problem, that is seventh one. A unit vector directed from region 2 to region 1 at the planar boundary between a dielectric conductor is given as an cap equal to 0.6 ax cap plus 0.8 ay cap. The y component of the electric field vector in the medium is 1. Okay. It is 50 volt per meter. What are the other components of E field and what is the surface charge density on the conductor? Okay. So we have to find out the surface charge density and also the other components of E field. Okay. Here what is normal component is given, but tangential component has to be found, and then the surface charge density rho s has to be found. Okay. So let us consider some electric field intensity E1 is some x component ax cap, ey1 ay cap plus some z component, that is ez1 into az cap. Okay. This is normal component. Okay. That is 0.6 ax cap, 0.8 ay cap is the normal component. Okay. Given the y component of electric field vector in medium 1, this ey1 is equal to 50 volt per meter. Okay, so you have to find out what is EX1 and then the EZ1. At the boundary between two arbitrary media, you know tangential ET1 is equal to ET2. Okay, or you can also write unit vector AN cap, which is normal to the surface. AN cap cross product with E1 minus E2 must be equal to 0. Okay, when you take normal component cross product with this E1 minus this E2 must be equal to 0. Hence, since region 2 is a conductor, there cannot be any electric field within the conductor. Okay, because region 2 is a conductor, on the surface there will be no, there cannot be any electric field within the conductor. Everything will be only there on the surface. Okay, as a consequence, this above equation will reduce to an cap cross product with E1. Okay, this E2 is 0, so it will be you can rewrite, express it as an cap cross product with E1 will be equal to 0. Okay, so hence it becomes 0.6 ax cap plus 0.8 ay cap cross product with ex1 ax cap plus 50 ay cap plus ez1 az cap must be equal to 0. Okay. So if you take cross product of these two vectors and equating it to 0 by taking here and equating it to 0, what you get one equation? You will get it as the above equation will be satisfied if and only if EZ1 is 0 or 30 minus 0.8 EX1 is 0. Okay. So but this EZ1 is not 0 because they have given there in the problem. Thus, we can find, write it as this 30 minus 0.8 EX1 as 0. Hence, EX1 will result as 37.5 volt per meter. Therefore, E1 vector can be written as this 37.5 AX cap plus, given in the problem, 50 AY cap. Okay. But Z component is here, it is given, it is 0. Okay. Also at the interface, one more thing we can write, something similar to the previous one, where A1, AN cap into E1 minus E2 is 0. Similarly, we can write AN cap dot product with D1 minus D2 is nothing but surface charge density. There the cross product of AN with E1 minus E2 is 0. Here AN dot product with DN minus D2 will result in surface charge density. Hence, again, D2 is 0, it is inside the conductor region. So, it, E2 is 0, that means D2 is 0. So, only resultant is An dot D1 will be equal to surface charge density. Okay. Hence, surface charge density is An cap dot with epsilon naught epsilon R1 into E1. Okay, by doing this dot product, it results surface charge density will result as 62.5 epsilon naught epsilon r1, so much coulomb per meter square. Okay. We'll take further next problem. It is two metallic plates, each having an area 100 centimeter square, are separated by 0.2 centimeter. In the region between the two plates, okay, we have a perfect dielectric with relative permittivity epsilon r equal to 1 plus 500 y whole square, where y is the distance from one plate to another plate. Okay, the surface charge density on the positive plate is 10 nano. Okay, one of the plate which is positive, the surface charge density is 10 nano coulomb per meter. Find the following: the total charge, dy component, electric flux density, electric field intensity, y component, the potential V naught, and the capacitance C. Okay, these are the things we have to find. First thing is, S is given, the separation D is given, epsilon R is given, and surface charge density D is given. Okay, sorry, rho S is given. First, total charge is nothing but surface charge density multiplied by area of any one of the plate. So it is rho S into S. Rho S is given, the surface charge density rho S, and it is 10 nano coulomb per meter, and the surface area S is given. Just direct substitution and multiplying, it is 100 pico coulomb, the total charge. What is dy? Using the conductor boundary condition, the dN is nothing but surface charge density. So dy is equal to rho S, which is nothing but 10 nano coulomb per meter square. If you get electric flux density, then electric field intensity is nothing but this dy divided by epsilon, okay, where epsilon r is also given. So ey is nothing but dy divided by epsilon naught into epsilon r. Okay, so it becomes this dy divided by epsilon naught, it is 8.854 into 10 power minus 12 multiplied by 1 plus 500 by whole square. Okay, so it becomes, after doing calculation, it is 1129 divided by 1 plus 500 by whole square. Okay, this is nothing but epsilon r value, is written as it is. Then what is potential difference? It is nothing but minus integral initial point to final point E dot dl. El is here, the electric field intensity is given here, but y is varying from, I mean the y limit is will be varying from 0.00 to 0. Okay, so by doing this with respect to y, integration, substituting for ey here and then integrating with respect to y and substituting for y limits, the potential V naught will result as 1.129 volts. Okay, hence the capacitance C will be equal to Q by V naught. This we know, so Q is already there, V is also there, so capacitance is nothing but 88 point. Direct substitution results in the numerical calculation as 88.57 picofarad. Okay. We'll take the next problem. It is two metallic spheres have radii of A equal to 2 centimeter and B equal to 5 centimeter. The space between them has two dielectrics, okay, it is epsilon r equal to 10 and theta varying from 0 to pi by 6, and epsilon r equal to 1 for theta varying from pi by 6 to pi. Okay, find the capacitance C. Okay, first we'll try it for this, for epsilon r equal to 10 and theta for between 0 to pi by 6. Okay, let the solution goes like this. Let the potential difference between the two spheres be VA, V naught volts. Okay, also the outer spheres let it be grounded. Okay, the electric field intensity varies inverse to R square. Okay, so hence you can write E, electric field intensity in air will be equal to E field in dielectric, which will be equal to constant K divided by R square volt per meter. Okay, further, what is potential V can be written as minus this K by R square, this E differentiating, sorry, integrating this E over a differential length, that is minus integral E dot dl. Okay, so by doing that, where k is nothing but can be written as v naught divided by 30. Okay, just direct substitution doing the integration will result k equal to v naught by 30. Okay, and v naught d air will be nothing but epsilon naught into e air. Okay, so where e air can be written as epsilon naught v naught by 30 r square. Okay, by substituting this k value, here, so on this we get electric field intensity. So electric field intensity, once you get, you can find out the electric flux density. Okay, so further, once you get the electric flux density in the air medium, let us find out the flux density in the dielectric medium, which will be nothing but 10 into epsilon naught E dielectric, which will result in 10 into epsilon naught V naught divided by 30 R square. Okay, is the flux density in dielectric medium. Further, what is this surface area? S dielectric can be, it will be equal to surface integral, that is integral 0 to 2 pi, integral 0 to pi by 6, this r square sin theta d theta d phi. Okay, what is radius r? It is 0.02 square. Okay, and then integrating, what you get? S dielectric is 0.0085 into 1 minus cos 30 degree. This can be substituted. Similarly, S in air, the surface area in air will result in 0.0085 into 1 plus cos 30 degree. Okay, so what is the charge in the air plus charge in the dielectric medium? It is nothing but total charge will be equal to d air into S air plus d dielectric into S dielectric. Then just direct substitution, whatever has been calculated here, it has been substituted here. Hence, the total charge will result as 5.94 into V0. Okay. By getting this charge Q, we can find out the capacitance C, which will be equal to charge Q divided by V0. Okay, which will result in this 5.94 divided by V0. V0 and V0 will get cancelled. So, the capacitance is nothing but 5.94 picofarad. We'll consider the 10th problem here. It is a current filament carries a current of 10 amperes in AZ cap direction on the Z axis. Okay. Find the magnetic field intensity H vector at point P with coordinates 1, 2, 3. Due to this, a filament, if it extends from, there are three parts in this problem. First one is it extends from minus infinity to plus infinity. Part B is if it extends from 0 to 5 meter. And part C is it extends from 5 to some infinity. Express the answers in Cartesian system. Okay. What we are trying to find here is the magnetic field intensity H vector. First we'll do only for part A and then we'll move on to the part B and then to the part C. Okay. So let us consider this figure part A, where the current filament is extending from minus infinity to plus infinity. It is going from minus infinity to plus infinity. Okay. So it is an infinite conductor, so which is carrying a current of 10 amps at some point P with coordinates somewhere here. It's a point P with 1, 2, 3. Find out the field, magnetic field intensity. Due to infinite current carrying conductor, the part A solution, infinite current carrying conductor, the H vector will be equal to I divided by 2 pi R A phi cap. Okay. What is R? R is nothing but root of this distance. R is nothing but root of X square plus Y square, because this is Z direction. If you take the perpendicular distance, is nothing but radial component. So if you take this a point P, 1, 2, 3, if you take a perpendicular distance, then this distance will be nothing but here the same Z value. Z and Z will get cancelled. So it will become 1 minus 0, 2 minus 0. So it will become root of 1 square plus 2 square. That is R. Okay. So it is root of 1 plus 4, which is nothing but root 5 meters. Okay. So magnetic field intensity H vector will be 10 divided by 2 pi into root 5 A phi cap, okay, which will be equal to 0.7117 A phi cap. This is for the infinite current carrying conductor. Okay. Further, what is this direction A phi? Let us try to find it out in the Cartesian coordinate system. Okay. For that, what has been found here is Hx component can be found as H dot Ax cap. Okay, so this phi dot Ax. What is phi dot Ax? It gives you sine phi. Okay, and for y component, it is H vector unit dot product with unit vector A phi, Ay cap. Okay, so what is phi dot y? It results as cos phi. Okay, so what is phi? Angle phi is nothing but tan inverse of y by x. Y and x are given in the problem as 2 and 1. By substituting that and calculating, phi will result as 63.4 degrees. Okay, and substituting here as sine 63 and cos 63 will get the hx and hy component. Hence, h vector will be 0.63 ax cap plus 0.31 ay cap. Okay, so this is for the part A. Okay, what is part B? Part B is that it is extending from z equal to 0 to z equal to 5. Okay, it is extending from 0 to 5. Okay, where again here the perpendicular distance is root 5 only. Okay? But you have to find out these angles which are connecting to initial point and the final point of the conductor. Okay, this angle alpha 1 and the angle alpha 2. Okay. From the figure, alpha 1 will be tan inverse 3 by root 5 and alpha 2 will be tan inverse 2 by root 5. Okay. So, which will result as minus 53 degree and alpha 2 as 41.81 degrees. Okay. So, we know magnetic field intensity can be expressed for a finite current carrying conductor as I divided by 4 pi r sine alpha 2 minus sine alpha 1 into A phi cap. Okay, so we can substitute for alpha 2, this is 41 degree, and alpha 1 as minus 53 degree, and then calculating here where r is nothing but root 5, it has been shown here. By substituting that, magnetic field intensity will result as 0.5225 A phi cap. Okay. But what is this A phi cap? Again, H vector dot product with AX cap gives you HX component. Okay, H vector dot product with unit vector AY gives you Y component. Okay, so same phi results as 63 degree, and substituting here for sine phi and cos phi, this angle 63 degree, HX component, then this is the HY component. Hence, the magnetic field intensity H vector will be minus 0.46 AX cap plus 0.23 AY cap. Okay. So, this is the magnetic field intensity H vector for the part B. We'll see the part C. Part C is we have to find out the magnetic field intensity due to the conductor placing from Z equal to 5 and it is extending up to infinity. Okay. So, again here we have to find out this angle alpha 1, initial angle, and the final angle alpha 2. Okay. The initial angle alpha 1 can be written as tan inverse. This is nothing but 3 to 5. So this length is 3 and this length is 5. So, this length will become 2. Okay. So, it will become alpha 1 will be tan inverse 2 divided by root 5. Okay. And what is alpha 2? Alpha 2 will be it is extending to infinity. So, it is tan inverse of infinity, which is nothing but 90 degree. Okay. So, alpha 2 should result as 90 degree. You see that? Yeah. Here it is part C solution. The conductor is extending from Z equal to 5 to infinity. Okay. Where the length r will be root of x square plus y square, which will be nothing but 5, root 5, and alpha 1 will be tan inverse 2 divided by root 5, which will result as 41.81 degrees. and alpha 2 will result as tan inverse infinity by r, which will result as tan inverse infinity nothing but 90 degree. Okay, so both alpha 1 and alpha 2 are positive, which are above the point. Hence the field intensity is I divided by 4 pi r, which is nothing but sin alpha 2 minus sin alpha 1. Okay, so by substituting this alpha 1 and alpha value and the current value and this length r, we get the magnetic field intensity as 0.12 a phi cap. Okay, so further this a phi cap can be found by finding the hx component and the hy component. So which to find hx component, it should be done in similar to this one. Hx component as h dot ax cap, hy component as h dot ay cap. By doing that and knowing this phi and substituting for this, we'll get the h vector in the Cartesian system. Okay, so hence we have done some numerical problems. We have almost everything we have recollected and repeated, and many problems we have solved. Knowing current density, how to find the total current we have seen. If it is given a differential volume, how to find the current. If it is given the surface area, how to find the current. Those things we have done. And after that, if the vector magnetic potential is given, how to find out the field in magnetic field intensity. These things we have done. And over a dielectric interface, how to find out the electric flux density. So these problems we have repeated and we have recollected and tried out, worked out more problems and more numericals in these two sessions. Okay, further we'll be learning about next few topics, all about time varying fields and the wave propagation in the next few sessions. Okay, thank you.